many thanks to the organizers of this workshop. I am pleased that you can speak here today. As we already heard in this session, it is a great challenge to develop interoperable data models, schemas, or ontologies for the highly diverse data of the historical sciences. Here we are always caught between the most accurate possible representation of complex historical processes and the formulation of standards that make the data machine readable and interoperable. These are the considerations, in short, why we built VIAC, a data hub for medieval and early modern research, which started last year. For VIAC, we decided to choose a data model that is as simple as possible and to focus on the benefits of entity linking via authoritative data and standard vocabularies. One of our main tasks is to transfer scientific data that was previously only available in print publications or in unstructured databases into the digital world. Without this, even the most sophisticated semantics cannot be of any use. Prosopographical data is recorded with a fixed metadata schema you see here. And when we speak of prosopography in our field of research, this means the systematic research of the clerical personnel of the Church of the Holy Roman Empire. The characteristic of this group of persons is that the individual elements of the group have an institutional affiliation that not only allows systematic access, but also identification. What kind of content do we need for the data hub? We need prosopographical data from reliable scientific sources. A huge number of such data is provided in our data collections. First, Germania Sacra's digital index of persons. Second, the database Bishops of the Holy Roman Empire. And third, the database Canons of the Holy Roman Empire. Through these databases, comprehensive collections for the ecclesiastical personnel are available the first time. They can now be used as reference databases. For the person's institutional affiliations, the database Monasteries, Convents, and Collegiate Churches of the Holy Roman Empire can be used as a reference database as well. For further information on the institution itself, the database Dioceses of the Holy Roman Empire offers standardized data. What we do have not is a vocabulary to designate ecclesiastical offices. As a research project in church history, we have the necessary expertise, so we started to develop such a vocabulary. Besides, we are preparing a typology of religious orders. One reason why we started VIAC is that only a minor proportion of entities for the research in the field of medieval and early modern times is available through existing authority providers such as the German National Library, GMD, and open domain knowledge collections such as Wikidata. But why did we build a separate knowledge hub? Alternatively, the data could be integrated into existing authority files. Within our project, we examined whether it could be a good solution to work with Wikidata to promote the generation and provision of interoperable data. We would like to take a closer look at this for the group of bishops. Only 57% of the bishops are represented by an article in the online encyclopedia Wikipedia. Although Wikidata provides more datasets for bishops than Wikipedia does, also here, the inventory of bishops was not complete. When we started the VIAC project, Wikidata contained 4,100 entries on bishops and other leaders of dioceses, which was 80%. After we published the database on bishops at the beginning of this year, we systematically added the missing data in Wikidata, so that Wikidata now also contains items for all 5,067 diocesan leaders of the Holy Roman Empire. We used semi-automated procedures to perform a data reconciliation between our data and those in Wikidata. Then we created new Wikidata items for all individuals for whom there was no entry yet. In order to be able to link the two data sets with each other, we created property for the bishop's database in Wikidata, which allows to integrate WIAC IDs as external identifiers. The linking on the basis of identifiers is technically easy to realize, whereas the process of data reconciliation that is necessary takes time and expertise.
Integrating data into Wikidata is challenging due to the heterogeneity of the data structure, which makes both data matching and serial queries difficult. This can be illustrated by this example. The slide shows the Wikidata item for Lothar Franz von Schönborn, Archbishop of Mainz and Bishop of Bamberg. His episcopate is indicated with the property position held. Due to the different users who have added data for this item, there are four different ways of modeling the data. In addition, one of the dioceses given here is the Archbishopric of Bamberg, but the Archdiocese of Bamberg was not founded until 1818. The Wikidata item Archdiocese of Bamberg clearly refers to the modern diocese and not to the situation in the 18th century. While in this example, several types of modeling meet in one dataset, on the other hand, there are a large number of datasets on bishops with only one of these modelings. Therefore, even simple queries quickly reach their limits. For example, the bishops of a medieval diocese cannot be reliably extracted. But there are still good reasons to map and integrate the data into Wikidata. It prevents us from storing our data in data silo. Data can easily be extended by the community. It is multilingual and represented in the world of linked data. We aim to combine the benefits of free and collaboratively developed data collections with the benefits of scientifically controlled data collections. We reconcile, structure, standardize, and provide domain-specific data not only from our own data collections, but also from project partners and scientific publications, which are not digitized so far. Data provenance can be stored for each record. In a narrower scientific context, it is much easier to establish consensus on metadata because, not least, direct exchange with peers and partner projects can be of great benefit here. Seen in a larger context, there's a lot going on in this field at the moment. Of course, we are following the current efforts to broaden the GND, and in the role of participants, we are part of the NFDE initiative. Here we have only talked about metadata on research results that have already been published. Thinking about unpublished research data, other systems come into consideration as well. One system we are currently looking at in more detail is FactGrid, an open collaborative wiki-based platform for historians. In a seminar for digital history at Göttingen University, we are currently working on a pilot project within FactGrid. Together with the students, we analyze data from the Repertorium Germanicum, that is from the late medieval papal registers in Rome. In particular, we are investigating the early business relations between the German bishops and the Florentine banking house of the Medici family. The collected data is stored in FactGrid. This way, your own research data can be directly reused and worked on by other researchers. Our strategy can be summarized in following 3 points. First, basically, we work with data models that are as simple as possible. Scientifically reliable and well-structured data, well-structured data is a first step for the integration of data into other systems, respectively into the linked data cloud. The collection of data is and remains an intellectual task for the historian. Both analog and digital information must be processed in such a way that they meet scientific standards. The net of data is only as good as its content. Third, citizen science projects like Wikidata and Wikipedia fulfill important functions, especially regarding the networking of data and technologies of the semantic web, but they cannot replace scientifically curated data collections. Thank you very much for your attention.